Saint Anselm and Southern New Hampshire, it's a battle for the bragging rights of Manchester.
Another long three for DeSantis. He's feeling it early. Two for two for Greg DeSantis. Team doing very well this season. DeSantis pull up from the elbow, knocks that one home. Eight quick points for Greg DeSantis.
Not going to be too unhappy to see that young man go away.
Stapleton straight on for the jumper, and that's point number 1,000 and 1,001 for Tory Stapleton, the junior from Railway, New Jersey.
Congratulations to him on reaching that benchmark.
Oh, back in the game, advances up quickly, but gets caught up in the air and turns it over. Woodhouse to Beaudenay in transition. Nice bounce from Mariano in the right lane to lay it in. Pump fake, dribble drive off the window. No good by Croto. Tip won't go. Very close inside Verasca, third chance, and he scored. Croto as the trailer fires for three and hits it. Marrero tries to create something. Back to Stapleton, takes the two-pointer straight on and hits. Stapleton, who scored his 1,000th point earlier in this half, to the basket and flips it up and in. Time at the Fieldhouse, and the Penmen faithful get up in appreciation for their team's efforts. They've been the better team. They were the better team right from the start today. Southern New Hampshire taking a 32-20 lead into the locker room. Beaudenay on the cut. Nice feed from Keogh when he lays it in. Penmen have continued with their solid play after the break. Keogh inside for two and a chance for three. Matowski. Beaudenay in the corner for three. Got it.
A much needed basket there, and that brings the St. Anselm bench to one.
Beaudenay in the post. Fadeaway jumper baseline. Got it. Looks like Beaudenay's got that shooting touch finally going. He's got nine. Remember, this is a player who has scored 40 twice this year. Stapleton inside, powers it up, and scored plus one. Beaudenay a little late on the rotation. Up in the lane, forces up a bad shot, misses it, keeps it alive on the glass. Offensive putback, yes for two and one. Croto on the right, tries to get Harris up. Back for Verasca, who lines up the three. Got it. Big shot by Corey Verasca.
Oh.
And picked by Harris, stepped in front of DeSantis, takes it to the basket on Marrero, who blocked it. Oh, what a block by CJ Marrero. At the other end, Stapleton inside for two and a chance for three. That could be a turning point that puts the Penmen over the top. Hawks won't foul, and that will do it. Southern New Hampshire University leads from start to finish as they knock off their crosstown rival, St. Anselm. Final score is 65-54.
Dave Spiro joining me, Coach. You talked about halftime, said you have to play at that level of defense. Weren't sure you'd be able to do it again. You took a pretty good punch and you hung in there tonight. Talk about the team's play.
We did. You know, we were not going to hold them to 20 points again. Both know and these kids are, you know, too good of players. But I thought we did enough. You know, we made enough stops. Every basket they really scored, other than a couple layups, because we were double teaming, they had to earn. So I got to give the kids a lot of credit.
Talk about, you know, you seem to take a pretty good punch from them. They got to within four in the second half. Corey made a big three for you. Seemed like every time they made a little bit of a run, you seemed to have the answer.
Yes, we did. You know, tonight we did because Verasca made that key three for us. But, you know, we talked about it at halftime. They're too good of a team, especially on the offensive end, not to make a run at us. And we said, if they do, just hang in there. We'll call a couple timeouts if we have to, and they regroup.
I have to say, you know, you struggled early on. Yeah, it didn't get off to a great start. Now you've got consecutive wins over Assumption and St. Anselm. Where's this team going right now? Feel pretty good?
Well, you know, we're only as good as, you know, the shots we make. You know, when we make some shots, like we started the game with a couple deep threes, gave us some confidence. And we played basically all the tough teams tough. We lost, you know, six or seven games by less than 6 points. So we can compete with these teams. It's just a matter of being more consistent on the offensive end.
I have to ask you about the play of Tory Stapleton. I thought he was, he's been good for all year. He was sensational tonight.
Well, he was tonight. You know, he's been up and down all year. Last year at the end of the season, he probably had eight of his best games of his career. And hopefully he might do it again this year for us.
Coach, congratulations on a good win. Congratulations, first of all, on the win. Let's talk about this one. First of all, the victory and what it means for the team.
It means a lot, crosstown rivalry, and we went down there to their place, we had them, and we ended up losing the game, so, you know, it's a big victory, you know. I actually got a text from some of the alumni, and they told me that this is bigger than the Super Bowl to them, so, you know, so it's a big win for us.
I know we don't like to talk too much about individual accolades, but you surpassed 1,000 points tonight, junior year, had to feel pretty good about that.
Yeah, it felt pretty good. You know, I just wanted to come out here and get the win, you know. Took a back seat, definitely, you know, coming off the bench. And, sure. And Corey Bowen's been playing, you know, solid minutes. So, you know, this year I just wanted to come in and, you know, put my stats aside, you know. So I'm not too worried about it. You know, it's a big thing, but, you know, maybe down the line I'll appreciate it a lot more.
I hear you.
I'm just more happy that we got this win tonight.
Your coach said that you played your best basketball around the second half of last year. You feel like you're getting it going a little bit at the right time?
I feel like it's around that time of year. You know, I'm growing the hair out. I don't know if you guys see. You know, so it's really just grind season right now, and just trying to get a flow, you know, and try to get in the rhythm of things. So
back-to-back wins for this team, obviously a huge win tonight against your crosstown rival. You feel like this team's going in the right direction?
Definitely. We started out a couple years ago. We started out 8-9, so it's a little different. We were 8-11 at one point this season. So I feel like we definitely, you know, have an opportunity. If we can make the playoffs and win straight out, you know, you never know. You never know what can happen. You know, that's how our league is. So
Tory, congratulations on a great game.
Thank you, sir.
You're welcome, Tory Stapleton, on a big victory here tonight, Steve.